algorithm.
Shalom. I'm Kahan Tazadaq, and this is Tazadaq Doctrine, and this is a short. This is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent counsel, then please be advised. Everything we're about to give you is strictly for educational, informational, and entertainment purposes only. A statement or an invoice that you're typically sent in the mail is not a true bill. Therefore, Tazadaq owes them nothing. Now, this explanation is proposing a over-needed paradigm shift in our mindsets regarding what you've actually been taught or bills. You receive invoice and you have been falsely taught to believe that they're bills. You receive these things in the mail from creditors, corporations, including United States Corporation, according to 28 U.S.C. 3002, subsection 15F. So if everything commercial is a trust since 1933 under FDR, then lawful money, as we know, according to 1933, was taken out of circulation, then a bill cannot really be a true bill. They cannot be charging anyone anything since they know that we have no means of paying anything. Do you understand? Do you understand? Checks and all liability currency are promises to pay and essentially are actually a dishonor because payment is actually delayed. But in commerce, this misnomer can be forgiven. So when with Tazadaq then is a bill, logically it must be a request for us to authorize the release of our assets that is actually being held in a treasury account by the trustee, as the payment or the asset or the credit liability debt is zeroed out. This payment by equitable title transfer results in the extinguishing of the alleged debt. Now, I need you to pay particular attention that the amount on the bill is a positive number, which is a credit. It does not have parentheses around it or a minus sign in front of it, which commonly indicates a negative number. So, this positive number represents an asset that will actually offset the liability held by the corporation or the creditor for a commercial transaction. They just need our authorization done by an endorsement on the back of the alleged bill, which is actually their invoice, to get ownership of that particular asset amount so that they can actually apply it to the discharge of the liability on their books and set the amount off for settlement and closure. We have equitable title to the amount. We endorse the back of the bill, then the legal and equitable titles to the asset, which is actually a credit, are now vested in the one piece of paper. And when they endorse that instrument and return to that party, whoever you may be, if it's Tazadaq or whoever, when it's returned to that party that sent it, then that party is now the holder in due course of the legal and equitable titles to both the asset and the liability amounts for the account, and must then extinguish the alleged debt by the operation of law. The corporation is already holding both legal and equitable titles to the liability. They are also holding the legal title to the asset as implied to them, sending you the bill. The U.S. corporation, all their sub-corporations hold legal title to the asset since 1933, and trustees or agents thereof, per the proposed intent of House Joint Resolution 192, Public Law 7310, 1933 Trust. It's codified in 31 U.S.C. 1518. The only thing they are missing is the equitable title to the asset so that they could finally do the discharge to balance their books and extinguish the alleged debt. They have the charge, which is the debt amount. They just need the discharge, which is a credit, which is the asset amount, to balance the books back out to zero. Having both the titles for the asset, the credit amount, allows them to use that asset credit amount to perform their duty as trustee to extinguish the discharge of the liability of the alleged debt amount by operation of law. The trust law that are invoked when the legal and equitable titles are actually merged. So the bill is not a bill. It is an asset credit voucher containing the credit amount that Tazadaq must release to the trustee or the agent thereof by endorsing the back of the invoice what they tell you is a bill and returning it for value. This is a duty that the beneficiary or the agent thereof have been felon to perform, and that is you. This is Kahan Tazadaq, and this has been a short, and this is right now at True Bill. This is Tazadaq. That's how we want it. Shalom. Peace. Two fingers.